prayer is minor. Therefore, with all my heart, I entrust myself to this brotherhood, that through the working of the Holy Spirit, the example of the Immaculate Virgin Mary, the intercession of our Father Francis and all the saints, and with the help of my brothers, I may, in the service of God, the Church and all people, seek the perfection of charity.
And I, in the name of the Church and the Brotherhood, receive your vows, and on the part of Almighty God, I promise you, if you observe them, life everlasting.
Amen.
To the praise and glory of the Most Holy Trinity, I, Brother Mario Fumbelo, led by divine inspiration, desired for more closely the gospel and footprints of our Lord Jesus Christ, in the presence of the assembled brothers, placing my hands in yours, Brother Augustine Mwate, with firm faith and will, I vow to God the Father, holy and almighty, to live for 1 year in obedience, without anything of my own, and in chastity. I promise to observe faithfully the life and rule of the Friars Minor, confirmed by Pope Honorius, according to the constitutions of the Order of Capuchin Friars Minor. Therefore, with all my heart, I entrust myself to this brotherhood, that through the working of the Holy Spirit, the example of the Immaculate Virgin Mary, the intercession of our Father Francis and all the saints, and with the help of my brothers, I may, in the service of God, the Church and all people, seek the perfection of charity.
And I, in the name of the Church and of Brotherhood, receive your vows, and on the part of Almighty God, I promise you, if you observe them, life everlasting.
Thank you.
brothers, it is fitting to renew the vigor of the new life begun in baptism by continuing conversion. Receive therefore the habit of penance of St. Francis, which resembles the cross as a sign of your consecration, and the code of our seraphic father, that it may be for you a bond of the love of poverty. So the novice master who has been journeying with them for the past 1 year shall present the habit to each and every girl.
Yeah. Because of the situation that we are in, we won't hug them or shake their hands. I'll just ask us to give them a round of applause. We are new members of our order, and we thank God for that.
Thank you. life. We give you thanks for the gift of this day. Father, it is indeed in our gratitude that we would like to express our deep desires to you. Our brothers today have made vows. Heavenly Father, you know it all that it is never easy, but with your grace, but with your strength, and with your help, they will soldier on perfectly. We ask you, Father, that you may give them the light that they need. We ask you, Father, that you may always keep them in your love. We ask you, Father, that always and always there may be a light to those they are going to meet. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
And if there are any who have intercessions to offer, you are free to express your heartfelt desires.
We thank you, Lord, for these our brothers who have today made their first commitment. We pray that, Lord, as you continue to bless them, may you bless also their family members, wherever they are at home. May you grant them good health of mind and body. May you continue, Lord, even to call more to join our way of life. For this we pray the Lord hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for the countries of South Africa, Zambia, and Zimbabwe, those we have received in your brothers. We pray, Almighty God, that you may be with them. Bless all the prayers and all their works that they are doing in different parishes. For them we pray to the Lord, Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray that the fervent desire they have today may keep them until the end. Lord, hear us.
Immensely,
because of the sacrifice that they have made, may you be their light in moments of darkness, may you be their strength in moments of weakness, and may you bless all their efforts. And for all those parents and guardians of our brothers who have gone to the Lord, we ask that you grant them eternal rest. For this we pray to the Lord.
Lord, graciously hear us.
The COVID-19 situation is worrisome, and it has brought a lot of drawbacks, so that we are not even able to get back to our homes. Lord, we commend this situation into your hands, and we pray that, Lord, in your mercy, may you heal our country, may you heal our world, that once again we may have the freedom that we had in the past. May you open the borders, the boundaries, and the air spaces that people may freely get to their homes and rejoice with their families. For this we pray the Lord, Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For those who have been journeying with our brothers, that, Lord, may you continue to bless them, give them the strength they need. They see you, they need, as they give themselves totally to be at the service of the order. For them, Lord, we pray, Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
And for those prayers that are lying deep down our hearts, we observe a moment of silence. Knowing very well that we have a mother who wants to see us prosper and flourish, we pray through the intercession of Mother Mary and Tie of Knots and Helper of Christians, as we say, Hail Mary.
Full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
And we ask all this through Christ our Lord.
Makele, 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 makele,
promised they would find treasure in heaven. And so the company of angels and saints will sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim. He took bread and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together Francis, our Pope, and Eric Banda, our Bishop, and all the clergy.
Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in the mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us, all we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, our spouse, and with the Blessed Apostles, St. Francis, St. Clare, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
De Christo, con Christo, e in Christo, a te Dio Padre Onipotente, nell'unità dello Spirito Santo, ogni onore e gloria per tutti i secoli.